Hey guys, James here, and this is a walkthrough for Tales of Ixalia. Hey guys, welcome back to the walkthrough. In the last part, we tried to cross Visible Marsh and we made it to the midpoint. There's an upcoming boss fight, which is actually pretty difficult if you do it wrong.
Doesn't look like it. It's the Chimeriad.
More troops? They'll make us late for our rendezvous with Agria.
Doesn't bother me. Let us at him, Wingo. Pretty please.
That man in the back in the red armor, he's the king of this particular chessboard.
Understood.
There are only three of them. Take them out!
He leads from the rear.
And off he goes, rushing in again. Not that I mind. You're out of your depth.
Get the woman! Stop her!
Nice to get the blood boiling for a change.
Checkmate. Although this king was no better than his pawns. So you've come, Maxwell.
It appears we must face each other on the battlefield after all. What a sad end to this tale.
Thanks for wasting our time with that search in the mountains.
My pleasure.
Have you taken out Gilland?
I don't have to answer that.
Then let's change the subject. Step aside so we can pass.
I don't think so.
We will destroy the Lance. With it gone, Azul's victory is assured. Why keep us from our task?
It is the will of His Highness.
This battle is merely a stepping stone toward our true goal.
But it is an unnecessary step. One that could cost your lives. Who would be left to support the king?
His Highness can look after himself.
Unlike some people, he would never fight feebly from the rear.
And what is that supposed to mean?
Don't play dumb, Chief Ilbert. You were meant to lead, not hide. It was your duty to fight, not carry the rear. Noctigal became a tyrant because of your inaction. Your only recourse was to stain your hands with his blood.
Word spreads fast.
That wasn't Rowan's fault. Noctigal was responsible for his own actions.
Do not pass the blame. Individual fault is a petty thing when weighed against the good of a nation.
What do you mean?
The people need a leader to guide them. Otherwise, they will go astray.
Rowan is fully capable of handling that.
It is not that simple. I am just a military strategist. I'm unworthy of the throne.
But our king is.
And he has seen the path he must take to lead the people.
The Lance lies on that path. We will take it and add it to his power.
Don't make me say it again. We won't hand over the Lance of Kresnik, no matter what your reasons are.
And I won't let you interfere with Mila's... with Maxwell's mission.
Oh, no good on standing!
Ready yourself.
So be it.
Everyone, stay sharp.
Yeah!
Now this battle can go two ways, either A, very well for you, or B, very horribly. A few things that you should keep in mind. A, do not let them poop up, because they, like you, can link up and use linked arts, which deal a lot of damage, so do not let them poop up. B, quickly take out Preska as soon as the battle starts, there's something right here. C, do not yourself group up, because that means their attacks will attack all of you guys together. Which means they'll keep interrupting your attacks, which could lead to a fast game over. Zhao and Wingo will try to link up, so make sure you increase in distance while you're fighting Pressa. And hopefully, your other two members will be keeping Zhao and Wingo busy. I chose Alvin because Alvin can take a lot of hits. And all of them have super moves. Pressa's about to use hers. But it should only hit two of us. She chose Alvin. As you notice, I actually switched over to control Jude because I think Jude was a little faster.
So strong. So strong.
Not yet.
As soon as you defeat one, you practically can take it easy. Your next target should technically be Wingo. It should be Zhao, but Zhao has a lot of health. And Zhao's super move isn't as scary as Wingo's, so I usually take out Wingo first. Because Wingo's super move targets a large radius, which means a lot of us are getting hit by it. Zhao will target one person and kind of have a little bit of radius in his explosion, but it won't hurt all of us. Got a big hit, but Wingo should be dead. There.
Prepare yourself!
I found it surprising how Zhao chose to lead the target to throw her across the floor. But that's the AI, I guess.
Not yet! Rising Falcon! Look out!
Not bad.
From the Chimeriad.
Can't imagine fighting them all at once.
We'd still win, no matter what.
That's right.
As long as Mew's around.
I won't let anyone down.
All right, not bad.
There's always room for improvement. Your booster.
Right here.
You were willing to go that far to serve Gaius.
Sorry. I'm not interested in any last words.
Alvin! The battle's over!
Fine. I'll let her go, if you insist.
This is really how you live your life, huh? I'd watch your back around him. He's just playing with you now, and someday, he'll throw you away.
I'd like to think Alvin knows how I feel.
I have to know. Why do you seem to care so much about me?
Speak up, big guy!
Why won't you tell me? Hey, it's okay.
The Lance of Kresnik is just ahead. I know you all have a lot on your minds. But I must push onward.
Alright, so I'm actually gonna cut this video short because the next upcoming part is gonna be very long. So I don't want to be even longer. So instead, I'm gonna show you a clip of what would happen if you did not heed my warnings with this boss fight. I may have made it look simple, but it is not if you did wrong. So, but for now, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and enjoy this additional footage.
Oh, no good on standing!
So be it.
Everyone, stay sharp.
Yeah!
So this is what will happen if you group up and let them group up. They'll keep interrupting your attacks and they'll use linked arts, which will in the end cause you a game over. Unless you're super over level, which I don't think you will be.
Now that's not very nice.
But you're one to talk. It doesn't matter if he stands in our way. We will carve our path forward.
Stay on guard.
No mercy!
Not looking good.
Thank you.